Welcome to the second hour class. We are discussing about arches. We know why arches are provided. That is, if horizontal beams are provided for longer span, they are uneconomical, therefore arches will be provided. If you take arches, they are nothing but curved beams like this. The different nomenclature in the arches. If you take forces acting on the arches at any section, mainly the normal thrust, it is along the axis of the arch, radial shear and ebony moment. If you take classification, classification will be based on the material or maybe on the shape or maybe on the support conditions. If you take the classification based on the support points, if hinges are provided at 3 points, two at the abutment level, one at the crown, it is 3-hinged arch. This will be 2-hinged arch, wherein only two arch hinges will be provided at the abutments. And if arch is fixed rigidly to the abutments or supports, they are called fixed arches. Based on the shape, there are two types of arches: circular arch, parabolic arch. Whether you take circular arch or parabolic arch, they are statically determinate. Because if you take arch, there will be four reactions or unknowns: horizontal reaction at A and B, two unknowns; vertical reactions at A and B, two unknowns. These totally four unknowns can be found by applying four equilibrium conditions, and hence these 3-hinged arches are statically determinate. That is the meaning here. If you take the geometry of a circular arch, from the property of a circle, we know this half span into half span of the arch is equal to this height of the crown from the abutment level and this remaining distance, that is 2r minus h, because this is h. Full is 2r, because nothing but diameter, that is 2 radius. From this, if you simplify, r is equal to l squared by 8h plus h by 2. Then coming to the analysis of any point in the arch, to know the forces acting at any point, we should know the coordinate of that point. The coordinate of d in a circular arch, x will be equal to L by 2 minus r sine theta by the geometry of these things that we had discussed in the last class, and y will be equal to r cos theta minus r minus h. From this, full r minus h, this distance r minus h, it is h minus r minus h, r cos theta minus r minus h will be this much. That is the geometry of the circular arch we should know in the analysis. Coming to the 3-hinged parabolic arches, equation of the parabola, we know y is equal to 4hx by l squared into l minus x, where x and y are the coordinate of any point in the arch ACB, and h is the rise, l is the span of the arch. That is the equation of the parabola which will be used to find the coordinate of D. Now, if the hinges or support points are at different level, in that case, the span L1 will be different, L2 will be different, that the total span is L will be L1 plus L2. Similarly, height of the crown hinge from the different abutment or support levels are other 2 inches will be different. Therefore, let it will be H1 and this will be H2. Now these are related with this equation, and we should remember this property of a parabola for the further analysis. Coming to the analysis of the arches, whether it is 3 inches, whether it is 3 inches circular arch or 3 inches parabolic arch. Analysis means finding the support reactions and finding the forces at any point, and finding or drawing or finding the bending moment at a different point, and then drawing the bending moment diagram. As we discussed, statically determinate whether it is circular or parabolic arch by applying equilibrium condition, by considering the proper sign convention, the reactions HAVA, HBVB can be found easily. Now another point is normal thrust and radial shear. As we know, at any point, normal thrust is along the axis of the arch and radial shear perpendicular to the axis of the arch will be active. Normal thrust and radial shear. Now, for the equilibrium of this portion, if you draw free body diagram, if the external load W1 is acting in between A and D, then unbalanced force V and horizontal unbalanced force H can be found by considering the equilibrium. That is, by applying sigma, Fx is equal to 0, Ha is equal to H, or H is equal to Ha, because no other horizontal forces. If you apply sigma Fy is equal to 0 for this portion, plus Va, minus V, minus W1. From this, V can be found as Va minus W1. Now, if unbalanced forces at this point D, H and V are known, if the inclination of this normal thrust, it is the tangent drawn at point D, is theta, N can be calculated as, that is normal thrust, V sin theta plus H cos theta, and radial shear F is equal to V cos theta, like this, and my H sin theta, the difference. The bending moment diagram at any point, at any section D with coordinate XY, bending moment will be the sum of the moment in an equivalent beam minus the ordinate times horizontal thrust. That means here vertical loads will be causing the sagging bending moment. They will try to push the arch down, that is sagging, wherein horizontal thrust here will try to push the arch in this way, therefore it will create hugging. Therefore the net bending moment will be the difference of this beam moment and the moment due to the horizontal reaction, because that is sagging and horizontal reaction will cause hugging bending moment. Hence the parabola first with ordinate is equal to H into Y, at any point it will be drawn, and at this point H into H, that will be the negative bending moment. That is bending moment due to the horizontal force. And if it is so, the bending moment due to beam or loading are overlapped or superimposed, we will get the bending moment diagram like this. Therefore the net diagram will be this. This is negative, this is positive. You will see this drawing bending moment diagram in some examples. That is the analysis. Finding the support reactions by equilibrium condition, finding the normal thrust at any point by considering the free body diagram of that portion, and then drawing the bending moment diagram by calculating the bending moment at salient points. Now coming to the problems, numerical problems. Almost all the problems are very similar. We will deal some problems on the circular arch and we will deal some problem on the parabolic arch. Now here, a symmetrical 3-inch circular arch has a span of 16 meter. This arch spans 16 meter asymmetrical arch, and a rise to the central hinge is 4 meter. This rise 4 meter. Now it carries a vertical load of 16 kilonewton. This 16 kilonewton at 4 meter from the left hand hinge. That means horizontal distance. This is the left hand hinge A. From here, the load is acting at a distance of 4 meter, that is 16 kilonewton. No question is, fine, the magnitude of the thrust at the springings, nothing but the reactions, HA and VA. Further, if you want, you can find the resultant reaction at this point. HA and VA resultant reaction. That is just by a resolution we know. Resultant fighting of two concurrent forces. That is the magnitude of thrust at the springing. Now the reaction at the supports. Nothing but HA and VA. Now the reaction at the crown. ERC. Because for equilibrium, this is also hinge. This is in equilibrium. Reactions will be acting. That also it is as reaction at the crown hinge. Then normal thrust and radial shear at 3 meter from left. That means this is 4 meter. Somewhere here, any point D, which is at 3 meter. This horizontal distance 3 meter from the left hinge. It is as normal thrust and radial shear. Then bending moment at 6 meter from the left hand hinge. That means this is 4. That means somewhere here 6 meter they ask you to find the bending moment. And also the maximum positive bending moment. Maximum positive bending moment. We'll come to that later. Findings are 5 here. But all are simple what we are discussed. Now coming to, this is the figure for this problem. First read the question carefully and write the figure properly, especially the numericals. Span 16 meter, rise 4 meter, and the distance of the point load 16 kilonewton is 4 meter from the left hinge. These are all the four given datas. Now coming to the reactions, let HA and VA are the horizontal and vertical reaction at A. HB and VB are the horizontal and vertical reaction at the right hinge B. Now this arch is in equilibrium. Therefore, for equilibrium, if you apply sigma Fy is equal to 0, in doing so, I take upward forces positive, downward forces negative. That means plus VA minus 16 plus VB is equal to 0. Or VA plus VB is equal to 16 kilonewton. These are the three vertical forces. Component of horizontal forces HA and HB will be 0 along vertical axis. Therefore, only VA, 16 kilonewton, and VB will come into picture in the equilibrium condition sigma Fy is equal to 0. Therefore, VA plus VB is equal to 16. If you rearrange, let us call this equation number 1 because two unknowns. Then applying sigma MA is equal to 0. That is algebraic sum of the moments about A is equal to 0. You can apply about B also. Whichever it is convenient, it can be defined. Or it can be taken as moment center. While applying sigma MA, the equilibrium of the whole arch should be considered. Now, about A, we are taking the moment. HA into 0, because its perpendicular distance is 0. VA into 0, its perpendicular distance is 0. Now 16. We use sign convention clockwise like this. in the direction in which the clock rotates clockwise. I will take as positive. And the forces which are causing the moment to rotate the structure in the opposite direction of the clock rotation, it will be anti-clockwise, and that I will take as negative. Now coming to here, about A, HA and VA create zero moment because perpendicular distance will be zero. Coming to 16 kilonewton, about A, it is acting like this. That means about A, it is causing a moment like this. You should treat this as point hinged. 16, try to rotate about A, it will be rotated like this. That is, clockwise. That is 16 into 4. That is 16 into 4. It is plus 16 into 4. Then HB. The line of action of HB is passing through the moment center A. That means perpendicular distance is 0. This is the axis of the force. Our line of action of HB. Therefore, HB creates zero moment. Should be very careful. Then VB. About A, if you rotate like this, about treating this point as inch, VB acting up, that means it will be like this. It is anti-clockwise. We take minus. That is, VB into its perpendicular distance is 16. VB into 16, and it is minus because anti-clockwise. All the forces are covered, that's equal to 0. While taking the moment of HB about A, you should be very careful. Because HA and VA acting at A, it will be 0, no moment. But HB is acting here, thinking that we are multiplying perpendicular distance of 16 meter for VB. Don't multiply 16 meter for HB, because line of action of HB is this. If you produce it, it passing through A, therefore HB creates zero moment. This is very, should be very careful. From this equation, this is zero, this is zero, 16 into 4, this is zero, VB into 16. If you rearrange, 16 into 4 divided by 16, that means VB is equal to 4 kilonewton. If you substitute this in equation number 1, we get VA is equal to 16 minus 4, that is 12 kilonewton. That is, for part B, the reactions at the supports VA and VB we found. Now coming to finding HA. Now for HA, we should take the moment center as the crown hinge, that is C, this one. If you take crown hinge, it is the hinge. This portion of the arch A to C is in equilibrium, and this portion of the arch C to B is also in equilibrium. Therefore, while applying sigma MC is equal to 0, you should consider this side force or this side force for equilibrium. Not the whole, we should be careful. Nothing but considering the free body diagram of this or this. You can apply sigma MC is equal to 0, algebraic sum of the moments about this point is equal to 0. But by considering portion AC or CB only, not full. While applying sigma MA, we have considered full. But about MC, you should consider only this portion or this portion. Therefore, if you apply sigma MC is equal to 0, by considering right side. Why it is right side? Because if you consider right side, the forces which are coming into picture are only HB and VB. If you consider left side, three forces will be coming to, three forces will come into picture, HA, VA and 16. Calculation will be little bit more. Therefore, let us consider this side. About C, HB if you take, now you should treat C as an injured point. About C, if you try to rotate HB in like this line of action and direction like this, it is causing about C like this. It is anti-clockwise. Correct? It is like this rotating anti-clockwise minus HB into its perpendicular distance to the line of action, not this distance. The line of action of HB is along this line. Therefore, perpendicular distance of HB from C is 4 meter. Therefore, minus HB into 4. Sorry. It is clockwise. HB into 4. It is clockwise. Like this clockwise. Then VB about C, thinking that it is inched, rotate VB about C. It is acting like this, going like this. It is anti-clockwise minus, that is VB, the line of action of VB is along this line. Its perpendicular distance from C will be from ear to ear. This is the line of VB, means this is the perpendicular distance. This is the perpendicular distance, means it is this. Nothing but half of the span, 16 by 2, that is 8 meter. That is VB into 16 by 2. It is minus anti-clockwise. HB is clockwise positive. From this, HB you can find. That is 8 kilonewton. Horizontal reaction at B is 8 kilonewton. Now, if you apply sigma fx is equal to 0, considering the equilibrium of the whole arch, sigma fx is equal to 0, only two forces will come into picture, HA and HB. Taking rightward force component as positive, leftward force component as negative, plus HA minus HB is equal to 0, because no other horizontal forces, VA, VB, 16 kilonewton are vertical forces. They will not contribute into the sigma fx is equal to 0 condition. Therefore, plus HA minus HB is equal to 0. In other words, HA is equal to HB. We know HB is equal to 8 kilonewton. Therefore, HA is also equal to 8 kilonewton. Therefore, we found the reactions at A and reactions at B. HA we found 8 kilonewton. VA we found 12 kilonewton. HB is equal to HA, that is 8 kilonewton only, and VB is 4 kilonewton. That is the answer for the second part, the reactions at the supports. Now, the first part, the magnitude of the thrust. The magnitude of the thrust at the springings, that means here. We know two forces are acting. Here, like this, HA, VA, that is at A, this is the arch. Here we found HA and VA. HA is equal to HB is equal to H only. Reactions over. Now they asked to find the thrust at A. It is nothing but the resultant reaction here. That is resultant reaction we can call as RA. We know if two forces are acting and they are perpendicular, resultant reaction RA will be equal to H square plus VA square under square root. That is here, resultant reaction at A, nothing but the thrust at A, RA will be H square or HA square plus VA square. HA we know 8 kilonewton, 8 square, plus VA we know 12 kilonewton, 8 square plus 12 square, and a square root if you calculate, it will be 14.42 kilonewton. Now its inclination, if we want the inclination of the thrust or resultant reaction RA with respect to horizontal, this is alpha A if you want. This angle, inclination of the resultant reaction with respect to the horizontal, alpha A can be calculated as tan alpha is equal to VA divided by HA or H. For alpha is equal to tan inverse of VA divided by HA or H. This is the inclination that is at A of the resultant reaction with respect to A, tan inverse of VA by HA. That is what it can be calculated. VA we know 2 kilonewton, HA we know 8 kilonewton, it will be 56.31 degrees. Similarly, resultant reaction at B, here here is the another inch of the arch. VA, HA, HB and VB at B. If you want resultant reaction, that is what? Nothing but the thrust at the abutments or springing or supports. It is RB I am calling. RB can be calculated using HB squared plus VB squared under square. We know HB, nothing but HERH, 8 kilonewton, plus VB is 12 kilonewton. We get this 8.94 kilonewton. Now, to define that resultant completely, we should know its inclination, this with respect to horizontal, as alpha B. This alpha B can be calculated. Very similar to the previous case, tan inverse of VB divided by HB. That is tan inverse of VB is 12. VB is 4. This is 4 squared and this is 4 divided by HB, it is 8. 4 by 8, you will get inclination of the thrust at B or reaction at B. Tan inverse of VB by HB 26.57 with respect to horizontal. Now, reactions at the crown, that is the third part of the question. Now, to find the reactions at the crown here, we should consider the free body diagram of this side or free body diagram of this side, that is A to C or C to B. If you consider A to C, 1, 2, 3 forces will be coming into the calculation. If you consider right side, that is C to B, only 2 forces will be coming into the calculation. Therefore, better to consider the portion CB. You can consider portion AC also. You will get same answer. I consider this side CB. That means free body diagram of the portion CB This is the crown. Crown. That is C. This is B. Here, two reactions. We found they are HB and VB. Here, this distance is 8 meter and that is off span, and this is 4 meter, the rise. Now, to consider the portion CB for equilibrium at C, if you draw free body diagram, this reactions will develop. That means HC and BC, then only it will be in equilibrium. Now, by considering the free body diagram of the CB, this will be the free body diagram. Now you apply sigma fx is equal to 0. No other horizontal forces except HB, it is acting to the left side, therefore minus, plus HC, it is acting to the right side, that is why plus is equal to 0. HC will be equal to HB, and HB we found 8 kilonewton. Therefore, HC is also 8 kilonewton. Then applying sigma fy is equal to 0. If you apply sigma fy is equal to 0, by taking upward forces positive, that is VB is acting up, therefore plus. VC is acting down, therefore minus, that is VC. No other force will be are there, because horizontal force will not contribute to sigma fy. Similarly, vertical forces will not contribute to sigma fx. Therefore, VB minus VC is equal to 0. Therefore, VC will be equal to VB. VB we found it is 2 kilonewton. Correct? VB we found the 4 kilonewton. These are the reactions at sea. That is what it is there in the PowerPoint also. That is HC is equal to HB, 8 kilonewton. VC is equal to VB by applying equilibrium condition. That is reactions at crown. The reactions at the crown. Now normal thrust and radial shear at 3 meter from left. That means somewhere here. Now here lot of geometry is involved. Yeah, normal thrust and radial shear at a distance of 3 meter. Now we have the equation L by 2 into L by 2 is equal to H into 2R minus H by the geometry. By considering the chord length L by 2 and this distance H and this distance 2R minus H. That we have discussed already in the geometry of the circular arch with the property of a circle. Now, if you take this formula as granted, 4, that is the rise, we know 2R radius of the circular arch is not given, minus H again 4 is equal to L by 2 into L by 2, the span of the circular arch. The span of the circular arch is 16 meter, that is given. Therefore, 16 by 2. From this, radius of the circular arch can be calculated, that is 10 meter. Similarly, slope at D in circular arch can be calculated, that is at any point D, that is this theta D. Yeah. Theta d. It is sine inverse of L by 2 minus 3 divided by R. R we know 10 meter. This formula is here in the geometry. We can use this. This is the coordinate of the, from this theta, it is mainly these formulas are established to find the theta, to find the value of theta at any point with coordinates x and r y. As x is known, this theta will be is equal to L by 2 minus x divided by r, that is sine theta. From this, this formula is taken as granted. Here, that is sine theta will be equal to L by 2 minus H, so L by 2 minus X divided by R. From this, 30 degree is the angle, that is theta, inclination of the tangent at D with horizontal, nothing but inclination of the normal thrust at D with horizontal is 30 degree from the formula. Now to find normal thrust and radial shear at this point, we have to calculate VD and HD. Then only the normal thrust and radial shear here, it can be calculated. Now to find VD. Now this equilibrium of the portion between A and D, if you take here, sigma Fy is equal to 0 means VA is equal to VD, no other vertical forces. See, D is at 3 meter. There is a point load 16 kilonewton which is acting at 4 meter. Therefore, while writing the free body diagram between A to D, that external load 16 kilonewton will not come into picture. Therefore, VD will be equal to plus VA minus VD is equal to 0. Therefore, VA is equal to VD, or VD is equal to VA, that is 12 kN. If you apply sigma Fx is equal to 0, HA is to the right side plus HA, HD is to the left side minus HD is equal to 0, or HD is equal to HA. No other horizontal forces, because VD and VA will not contribute to sigma Fx condition. Therefore, HD will be equal to HA, it is 8 kN. Therefore, normal thrust and radial shear can be calculated. That is the normal thrust and N is equal to V T sin theta plus H cos theta. VD sin theta minus H cos theta, or HD cos theta. That if you substitute VD 12 kN, HD 8 kN, theta 30 degree, N can be calculated and it will be in kilonewton. Similarly, the radial shear which is acting at D, normal to the axis of the arch, can be calculated as VD cos theta minus HD sin theta. VD, it is 12 kilonewton. HD, it is 8 kilonewton. Theta, 30 degree, and it can be calculated. Answers that you should able to calculate, should write. Okay. Now that is for the fourth part, that is normal thrust and radial shear at 3 meter from left, some area. By considering this free body diagram, it is analyzed. Now, the remaining two parts are about the bending moments. It is asked to find bending moment at 6 meter from left and inch. That means it will be some area. Some area. Therefore, we should draw free body diagram of the portion from A to 6 meter horizontal distance from A. Draw it will be 6 meter, that is here 6 meter, this is A. This is some point E, say. Bending moment at this point is required. Now, at 4 meter, if you try to draw free body diagram, external load 16 kilonewton is acting at a distance of 4 meter. Then the forces at A are HA and VA. Now, bending moment at this point is required. Correct? Bending moment at any point is the algebraic sum of the moments either to the left or right of the point or section considered. Okay? We'll consider left side. The forces which are causing bending moment at this point are 16 kilonewton, HA and VA. Three forces are responsible. Now, VA causes beam to bend like this about C, I'm sorry, about E. It is acting up like this means it will try to bend the beam in like this. Concavity upward, convexity downward, that is sagging. VA creates sagging bending moment about E. Therefore, it will be VA into its perpendicular distance. See, the line of action of VA is here. If you want perpendicular distance from E, means this is the perpendicular distance. It is nothing but 6 meter. That is VA into 6 meter. Then this 16 kilonewton, it is causing like this. It will try to bend the arch like this. About E, it is try to bend the arch like this. Correct. That is concavity downward, convexity downward, upward. Therefore, it is hugging. 16 kilonewton is causing hugging bending moment, that is minus 16 into its perpendicular distance from E. It is this distance. The line of action is this. Perpendicular distance from E means this. It will be very easily 6 minus 4, that is 2 kilonewton. Now, HA about E, it is acting like this means it is trying to cause or bend the arch like this. Correct? Like this, because it is acting like this. Therefore, again, convexity upward, concavity downward, therefore hugging. Therefore, minus HA into its perpendicular distance is nothing but YE is equal to 0. HA into YE or Y6 distance, this is also called YE or Y6 at 6 meter horizontal distance is equal to 0. HA we know, 8 kilonewton we found. VA we know, it is 12 kilonewton. Therefore, only unknown is YE, vertical distance. Because the line of action of HA is here. The line of action of HA is like this. This distance is the perpendicular distance. That perpendicular distance is the task here. Because that distance should be found here. You see the geometry for this figure. D, VD, HD. Okay. Y 6 meter. It will be Y6, 3 meter, YD. It is H, it is full 4 meter, minus R into 1 minus cos theta. That is Y6 is 3.8 meter. That is the geometry here. H this full edge, R that is the radius, R cos theta, R minus R cos theta. R cos theta is this, this distance. R full, full is R minus R cos theta is up to this. Therefore, this should be deducted. Full H minus R cos theta is this. That is the geometry. You understand? I'll explain the geometry here. Oh, it is time already. Okay, I'll come to this calculation in the next hour. Then we will see what to do. I'll complete this problem in the next class.